This video is sponsored by Modern Fertility.
Come on,
come
husband.
Get me, cause it's come ghetto get, out
come
here.
Pick her up. It's ghetto in these
it's
streets.
It's ghetto.
But don't pick me up.
Right.
Yeah, so.
Hey gems, it's Cindy Rilla OG. Welcome back to my channel. So today, guys, I am here with my girl, Shakima.
Hey.
And we are going to be doing a Tipsy Tuesday today. And as you guys can tell by the title, there are a lot of strong opinions that are going to be shared today about the subject. So today we are going to be talking about the societal pressures about women getting married, having children, and ageism, really, that occurs with women. And I'm very excited to get into the topic. So before we get into the topic, do you want to tell everyone, like, what your age range is, how old you are?
Yeah, I don't care.
Good, okay, you know. They always say don't ever ask a woman her age.
Right.
So I try to be as respectful as I can, but, you know, I always say I'm 25.
Right, lucky for 25. Me, I don't look my age. So
you really don't.
You know.
You really don't, y'all. Before we get started, guess her age.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and tell them how old you are.
Okay, so I'm 28 years old, just turned 28 in February.
Good. Yes, she did. She sure did. Right during the snowstorm. But it's all good because, you know, she is healthy. Mm-hmm. She is beautiful. She is vibrant. She is successful. Right? And you can only get better from here, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So before we go ahead and get into what today's activities are, Shakima wants us to take shots.
Yes.
Now, y'all know on Tipsy Tuesdays what I usually do is indulge in wine. That's what we usually do. But Shakima doesn't like wine.
Yeah.
So whatever Shakima says goes.
Basically.
So we are going to be drinking shots. We're going to be taking shots.
I'm going to call it Tequila
Tuesday
for now.
Tequila Tuesday. What is going on my channel?
Oh.
So go ahead and bring the cups, girl. We are going to try this one thing that we saw on TikTok that she sent me before I get crucified again.
Right. Because you tried to steal my idea.
She sent this to me, and y'all know I hate drinking, and I'm a lightweight.
Same.
So one shot will get me there.
This is about to be hectic.
It is going to be hectic. So I'm very scared.
Okay, so
that's enough.
Because you never know.
That's enough. Because.
Tell me when to stop.
We're already silly as it
right?
is.
Right.
That's enough. That's more than.
Oh, jeez. It is a lot.
You want me to drink all that?
Just do what the thing said. Breathe. What did it say? Okay, so we breathe out.
If I throw up, y'all. If I throw up, y'all. Listen. If I throw up, y'all.
I'm gonna take care of you.
Gross. Oh, okay. All right, it's okay. Give me a lemon.
Okay. Which one you want? Like a small one?
Yeah.
This is really a terrible idea.
I know.
Because it's so sour.
But okay. I like lemonade, so I think it works. I don't even know how we're going to do this. Okay, let's put a little lemon on our fingers.
No, you got to. Oh, yeah.
You right. Oh, actually, you right.
So
oh,
you
yeah.
So you rub it. Rub the lemon. And then you get the little bit of dash of that.
Oh, shit. No. All right. Okay, wait.
The TikTok said we breathe out and then take a shot and then breathe out again, right? Okay.
All right.
Ready? Okay, no, that wasn't. That was
wasn't terrible.
The salt really kicked my ass. Okay, but wait.
That was not terrible.
That kind of works.
And the lemon definitely worked.
Yeah.
It did, right?
Yeah.
Because it was my idea, y'all. Because I don't got no limes in here. I only got lemon because that's what I cook with. But we took that shot.
Yeah.
We actually took it like G's.
Champs.
That is better than I have ever taken a shot before.
No, for real.
Way better than I have ever taken a shot. So I would like to say I'm proud of myself. And, you know, if we decide to drink more, then that's to our own discretion. But I did my shot. I did my shot, and it's Tipsy Tuesday. I'm not supposed to be drunk. Mine is too, but I'm trying to hold it together. So, let's go ahead and get right into Le Topic. So, Shakima, can you tell me what it is that you're doing right now? What would you say is your life stage right now?
Like in terms of dating or just in life?
In life. And you can throw in dating too.
Yeah. Okay. So life wise, I'm really just living life. Like I'm just doing all the things I want to do. Mm-hmm. Kind of not putting any like bars on myself.
Absolutely.
And just, you know, if I wake up and decide I want to travel somewhere, I go. If I wake up and decide I want to do whatever, I just go and do it.
Yeah.
Living my best life.
Yeah. Period. Okay. And I think one thing that we always have talked about as friends is like mm-hmm. we're always growing.
Yes.
And there's always things to learn.
Mm-hmm.
Like we went to Jay Mulan's Women Empowerment event together.
Yeah.
And I think that was a really awakening moment for the both of us. And like, you know, I wouldn't say that we're in two different like too different of a age range,
yeah.
honestly.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you are a bit older than me, but, like, you
right.
know, I'm still, like, I'm up there now.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
Now,
yes.
I'm up there now.
Welcome to the club.
Yeah, I'm up there. So, I think, you know, one thing that we both, like, you know, discussed in our friendship is that we are constantly learning, and
yeah.
it doesn't matter who it's from. Like, we're always learning from each other, from people,
mm-hmm.
from experiences in general. So,
right.
yeah, you know, I think that is an important thing to note.
Yeah.
There is no cap on learning.
Literally. Like you said, there's no age limit.
Mm-hmm.
There's nobody that we can't learn from. Like,
yeah.
we've learned from each other.
Yeah.
We learned when we saw the women at Jay Mulan's event, we learned a lot.
Yeah, we took notes.
Yeah.
Yeah, we took notes.
That was a really good event.
And there's nothing wrong with doing that, like knowing to like be vulnerable in a
yeah.
moment and learn from who is willing to teach.
And ask for help.
Yeah, ask for help.
Ask for help.
Asking for help is essential.
Yeah, definitely.
So in you know, saying that,
mm-hmm.
have you had to deal with the pressures of family, friends, or even your peers, like, you know, seeing what they might be doing with their lives? Have you ever had to deal with the fact that, okay, maybe this wasn't what I wanted for myself at this age based on what I was raised to want or based on what I saw growing up?
Yeah.
As an example, or, you know, have you had to deal with that?
Yeah, I have. So around your age,
mm-hmm.
it kind of got to the point where, because, you know, like, I was always trying to do the entrepreneur thing.
Yes.
In hair. So there was a time where I had to take a step away from school. And I did have that moment where, like, self-comparison, where I was comparing where my journey was
yeah.
to other people. And I kind of felt like I, maybe, like you said, maybe I didn't pick the right decision, or maybe I wasn't moving as fast as everybody. But then I had to kind of realize, like, in general, that I was just a late bloomer, and there was nothing wrong with that. And kind of everything for me came on its own time.
Yeah.
The thing with me and what I've learned is, even though I'm always kind of like the last one, I'm the grandest. Like,
yes.
So when stuff happens
for me, that was a word.
Yeah.
Can you say that one more time?
Okay. Even when I'm the last one, mm-hmm. I'm the grandest.
Yeah.
When God delivers for me, He delivers in a big way for me.
That's for me too.
Yeah.
That's definitely
like,
for me too.
Right. So it's like, you know, like in the moment, you're like, dang, like I'm losing. Like I'm not where everybody else is at. And then everybody else does their thing. And then you pop out and it's like, oh,
yeah.
It's what, like, the heck? And
you,
it's
finally
a story.
Your flowers.
It's a testimony.
Yeah. Definitely,
and honestly, because everybody's seeing you, probably was like, you know, what are they doing? Like, what are they up to? And then you're like, hey,
mm-hmm.
I have God did.
I've always said that, like, through every testimony, there has to be a test.
Yeah.
There always has to be a test.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's something that we have to kind of accept growing into, like, you know, our older age, is that, like, you know, the times that we're being tested,
mm-hmm.
that is for the triumphant moment.
Yeah.
That is for whenever we make it to the end, when we can say, yo, y'all don't know how I had to go through, man.
Right.
I'm here, and I'm happy about it. So, let's talk about dating.
Okay.
LOL. So, as, do you have siblings?
Yes, I have a little brother.
Okay, so you're the oldest.
Yes.
Like me.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever had pressure from family members, particularly parents, to be in a relationship, a serious one, think about marriage, think about starting a family?
So, fortunately for me, my mom is a very, like, free spirit.
Yeah.
And she is definitely an advocate of me living my life right now.
Mm.
Of course, I would think she want grandchildren, but she just really, like, Kima, I want you to travel the world, because my mom had me at a young age.
Mm-hmm.
So for her, she's like, I wish I could have did things a little bit differently.
Yeah.
So she's like, I want you to travel. I want
yeah.
you to do kind of everything you want to do
yeah.
and then worry about finding a man and, you know,
absolutely
doing that. But unfortunately for me, I've always been a family person, so I've always kind of put that on myself.
Yeah.
Because I grew up in a, I don't want to say a broken home, but my parents weren't together. So yes. I've always kind of yearned to have that family.
Yeah.
So, especially in my younger 20s, I really wanted to be a wife and push for that stuff. And then I kind of like, as I got older, I was like, that's not the end of the world. So, yeah. But other than that, no, but like my grandparents, I kind of want to give them.
Yeah.
Before they, you know, go to the Lord, I would like to give them a
great child. You're lucky to have your grandparents. None of mine.
Yeah.
Okay, I hear you. So, one thing I think that sometimes worries me, and I'm just so scared of everything, like everything. I really am. I'm scared to ever even be on birth control because I'm like, okay, what if it never goes back? You know what I'm saying?
I
like,
do that.
Yeah, I'm like, what if I can't have kids anymore?
Yeah, I don't trust that.
So I even sometimes think, okay, maybe I need to start trying to, like, you know, plan for that future. And, you know, little ad here. One thing that I think has been made available to me recently is Modern Fertility.
Okay.
They are a company that, I'll go ahead and let myself do the talking.
You've probably thought about the next step in your career and your relationship, and also about planning for kids. Women are having children later in life, but biology has not changed, and we need tools to help us understand our reproductive timelines. That's why Modern Fertility was created. It's the affordable and easy way to test your fertility hormones at home with a simple finger prick. Mail it in with a prepaid label, and you will get a personalized result within 10 days. Right now, Modern Fertility is offering listeners $20 off the test when you go to modernfertility.com/Cinderella. That means your test will cost $139 instead of the several hundreds or even thousands of dollars that it would cost in a doctor's office. Get $20 off of your fertility test when you go to modernfertility.com/Cinderella, spelled C-I-N-D-Y-R-E-L-L-A. modernfertility.com/Cinderella.
Yes, basically, Modern Fertility allows you to, in a modern way, figure out what's going on with your eggs. If you're planning for the future, even if you don't want to have a child right now, what are my chances? What is going on for me to where I can know how to plan ahead?
That's good, because I always, even though like I'm not in a serious relationship, I always wonder that. Like, am I able to have children? Because I don't want to wait until I get in a serious relationship and find out that I can't.
Me neither.
Yeah.
So, that is Modern Fertility. So if you guys would go ahead and check them out and use all of my information in the description box down below to go ahead and get yours, because it is important.
Yeah.
No matter what age you are.
But especially though, when you're getting closer to like the 30 age range, like me, it is important.
I need to, girl. Yeah. I'm over the hill now.
Okay, but you just made over the hill.
You're right.
I'm like knocking on 30.
But okay, all right, back to the conversation. Okay, but given your own expectations for yourself, do you feel like you have a pressure to find someone? And what do you think are the limitations to you finding someone right now? And honestly, every 28 and up, or 27 and up, or even 25 and up year old woman dating right now.
Yeah.
A black woman, to be specific. What do you think?
And a very independent and strong
black
woman. Yes. So it's a little bit harder.
Making money, okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So that's a little bit harder. But okay, so in terms of like my own, I guess, limits on myself, everybody knows, they say, like, you know, once you hit 30, having kids after 30, it's a little bit harder. Yeah, so it's like, I try not to put the pressure, but it's in the back of my mind. Like,
yeah.
And that is like, I want three kids. Like, in a perfect world, I would have three kids.
Yeah.
But realistically, I would have to start having kids like right now to safely have those children.
Yeah.
So I've just kind of come to the terms of like, okay, what does that look like for me in a couple of years if I haven't found a partner? Like, I've considered like adoption. I've considered, you know, co-parenting, like finding somebody that like, hey, okay, we may not want to be in a relationship together, but we could, because, you know, Kalani did that, like, and she did the whole co-parent thing, and I think we're kind of moving in the age of where it might be acceptable, like, Because, I mean, it's better to have an agreement than to force a relationship and then, you know, y'all don't work out versus knowing, like, hey, we're here simply to create a child and take care of that child.
That's why I honestly encourage spirituality over, like, you know, hardcore judgment and religion, no matter what the religion is.
Yeah.
Because I think a lot of times people get really caught up in, oh, I believe that this is what the order is supposed to be. And for me personally, I do believe that in that order because that's just what I, again, put on myself.
Right.
Because of what I've been raised to know. And honestly, what I just want for myself in general as how I've been raised, right? So I think, though, it's really important for people to, like, more be based on spirituality and how they have their own relationship, whatever, with their higher being. Because when you are making your own decisions for your life, you cannot factor in what everybody else is thinking about what you are doing. You know what I mean? Now, I do believe that there are certain situations as to where it would be beneficial for the child to have both parents involved, but that's where co-parenting exists, you know what I mean? So, and partnerships, honestly. So, so I believe that families are so, like, multidimensional now to where so many different things can happen. I feel like people should more kind of mind their business.
Works in your house doesn't have to work at everybody else's
house. And that's just all it has to be. So I take pride in knowing that for me and what I want, it might not be the same as what somebody else wants, but am I going to judge or shame them for that? No. Am I still going to be that support system for whatever decision, like, my loved ones would make? Absolutely. You know?
And that's why I say, like, I think, like, ideally I want these things, but I've learned that... I've learned that life doesn't always go as planned.
So, if life went as planned, I would not be on this YouTube channel right here. I would be an
I don't even know.
I'd be some type of doctor.
Millionaire.
Yeah.
I would be rich.
And you know what? You could be rich and miserable.
Right.
You could be rich and miserable.
That's true.
So, did I say miserable?
Miserable.
Okay, I said, I don't know if I said that. Shit.
Should we take another?
I mean, are you dry?
Yeah, I'm sure. Because after we did that little breathing exercise, I was like, okay, I can handle this. My chest,
and she lives here, guys.
Yeah,
she lives downstairs.
Yeah,
so she's literally. I was joking about the whole driving thing. She's not going to drive home.
No,
she here. She's literally here. She's home.
I'm definitely an advocate for not drinking and driving.
Yeah, let's not do that. Let's drink responsibly.
Definitely.
All right. So let's remember how we practice it. Okay. I don't have to do the salt thing. I can just do lemon.
No, I'm gonna do it.
Okay. All right. I can just do lemon. Lemon is.
You use the same one.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm bougie.
Okay, tell me something.
I have to get a new salt.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
You know, I think I did that wrong.
You did. You need to breathe out.
Oh, but I'm talking about the salt thing. You're supposed to lick the salt first.
Really?
Then take the shot, then lime.
Just learn something.
I think so.
I just learned something because I didn't know that.
I don't take shots like this.
So. I don't take shots at all.
Yeah.
That's not how they. But, So, what do you see for yourself in the next few years then?
That's a great question. Ideally, I would want to be married with maybe like one or two kids.
Yeah.
And just owning my business. And being successful and traveling. I want to travel with my kids.
Me too. I want them to see the world.
I want my kids to have everything.
I want my kids to have everything too.
Everything.
In the next few years, I see the same for myself.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would like to be married.
Yeah.
I'd like to have a child or maybe like be pregnant.
Your wedding will be lit.
Girl, two party, you already know. You gonna come to Nigeria?
Yeah.
Okay. Exactly.
No, I'm an honorary Nigerian.
Yeah, no, you really are. She knows she actually is. Like, she has a parent in the household that is Nigerian. So. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Basically, mind your business. Don't ask women when they're they're getting married. Don't ask women when
or they're
trying
children. To have a kid.
Don't ask
that's
women
the rudest thing.
You don't know what people are going through. You don't know if people have been trying. You don't know if people have been traumatized to where they do not want to have children. You don't know what decisions that you're making for other people when you impress that question onto them.
Yeah.
So really just mind your business. And if it comes up, give your congratulations.
Right.
And that's it.
Yeah.
That's really it.
Right.
So I hope you guys took something from this conversation. If you guys have any pregnancy stories or if you have anything about your fertility that you want to talk about, if you are interested in modern fertility, go ahead and check them out in the description box down below. Make sure that you use my code as well. And honestly, guys, you know what? Live your life to the fullest. I hope you took some words from Shakima. I hope you took some words from me, and make sure to follow my girl on all of her social media, which will be in the description box down below. And if you're in Dallas, she's coming to the city soon. So if you need a silk press, holla at your girl.
Or a wife.
Or a wife. Yeah. Okay, I know you're watching out there somewhere. Her husband is out there somewhere. Come on,
come
husband.
Get me, because it's ghetto out here.
Come pick her up. It's ghetto in these
it's
streets.
It's ghetto.
But don't pick me up.
Right.
Yeah, so. But I will see you guys in the next video. I hope you guys have enjoyed City Rubathon, and I will see you guys later. Stay blessed and beautiful, gentlemen. I love you guys so much.